another day at the office, I guess. Well, as we've seen just there, these days we all seem to be living with a lot of added stress and tension, like, you know, I don't know, maybe you have to fill in for your favourite TV host or something while he's away. Anyway, whatever it might be, this can lead to hypertension, or what's more commonly known as high blood pressure. And of course, to tell us all about it is GMA's resident doctor, Dr. David Spencer. G'day, Doc.
How are you?
Very good.
Good to hear.
So first and foremost, what causes high blood pressure, hypertension?
Okay, well, it's a difficult question, actually. There are a lot of different causes.
We have I'll throw you the curly ones, Doc.
Thanks for that. about 90% of people, we don't know entirely what's going on. About 10%, there are certain problems with the kidneys or different glands or sleep problems that can cause it. Other people, we know certain things that contribute to it. Things to do with genes. Men get
like
it more than women.
If they're too tight?
Very, very tight. Yep. Genes are very bad for your health. Men get high blood pressure more than women. Older people get it more. And people who were born with a very low birth weight get higher blood pressure later in life. And then there are a whole lot of lifestyle issues, which is the main thing I guess we want to sort of talk about, because they're things that we can change to then reduce our chances.
So what sort of things can people do to help with their blood pressure? I hear, is it omega-3 fatty acids are very good?
Yep, they can play a part. Well done.
I don't even have a stethoscope.
There's one there you can have it. Diet things are very important. So you're looking at your fat intake, looking at exactly what it is you eat, fish more than red meat or leaner meat is very important. Lowering the amount of fat that you eat is great generally. Mm-hmm. Looking at levels of obesity and trying to reduce that, so exercising more, reducing the amount of alcohol you take in. If you smoke and you've got high blood pressure, bad news. Stop smoking. All that.
Well, we've got a blood pressure taking machine.
A sphygmomanometer.
Here. What?
A sphygmomanometer.
You just made that up. But can we take the blood pressure of someone in the audience?
Yeah.
Geez, I wonder who we will choose.
Simple.
Maybe this person that has an empty chair next to them, David.
Hi there, I think this is Fabian, is it?
What's your name?
Huh? Fabian.
Have you met... Oh, sorry.
God,
oh,
that
thank
you.
Fabian,
yes.
Have you met Lindsay?
Yes, I have.
Are you going to the 21st?
Yes, I am.
Oh, it's going to go off. Are you going to go to the 21st?
Okay.
You going to the 21st? You going to the 21st? We're all going to the 21st. Okay, so we're going to take your blood pressure, Fabian. Have you had your blood pressure taken before?
Yes, I have.
What's a good blood pressure, like 470 over 290?
That wouldn't be great.
I'd
like it a bit lower.
I'm just making figures up.
No, well...
So what should we be looking for on this? I'll just get that answer.
Okay, this, as that mercury level goes up, that gives me an idea of what the blood pressure is.
Right.
So I've just put this cuff on,
Fabian.
This,
obviously you use the very latest technology here. This looks like a really very modern piece of equipment.
From my office.
So this is your personal one?
Yeah,
do you just carry it around like this?
I do.
Of a day?
That's the mobile one.
Walking up to ladies in the bar, would you like your blood pressure taken? It's starting to rise, baby! A bit of that? You do, it's all right. It's just between you and me.
Thank you. No, so now I'm just watching that blood pressure go down. That's the mercury level going down there. And I hear some sounds in Fabian's arteries as the pulse comes back at the level of her blood pressure. So I get two numbers there. Hers was 110 on 70, which is perfect.
You didn't even study. Good job.
Simple test to get done with a doctor once, twice a year. Only takes a few moments, and you get some answers and get an idea of whether you need to make some lifestyle changes or not.
Well, sounds good. As always, thank you, Dr. David Spencer, everybody. Thank you, Fabian. Good job. Good blood pressure. I'm going to start pumping up as we check the blood pressure of Moira.
Well, Georgia,
it's in bed with Rove. Well, in bed with Rove. In bed with Rove for today. Very happy to have her joining us today. Lauren Newton, everybody. Hello, Lauren.
Hello.
Ann-Maree Biggar, as always. And you couldn't do an in-bed segment without your missus. It's Belinda Emmett. Officially still Emmett.
Yeah, I couldn't be bothered changing it.
Good on you. Now, Lauren, before we get started, how's Dad? I'm sure everyone watching at home is very eager to hear how he's going. Travelling okay?
He's very good. He's having a well-earned rest. This is his first sick day in 14 years.
Can you believe it?
You know, you've got to have one. But he's good. He's having a rest and he'll be back next week.
Oh, he's got the weekend. Put the feet up. That's what I say.
Yes, he'll be watching. So, hi, Dad.
Yes, and hi. Thinking of you as always. Now, of course, let's get straight into the questions from Wilma Lou. My girlfriend has told me she would like me to dress up for... Girlfriend? From Wilma. Her girlfriend has told me she would like me to dress up for her in the bedroom. She wants me to wear her stilettos and suspenders because she says she finds it attractive. I think it will be degrading, but don't want to disappoint her. Should I partake in her fantasy ladies?
I'm confused. Is it a girl wanting a girl or a bloke and a girl or a bloke?
I think it's two ladies. I'm so excited. Two ladies. And it's like she wants her to dress up, not in like a, you know, a pirate costume or a pantomime horse outfit. It's stilettos and suspenders. That's all right, isn't it?
Well, I think it's a girl.
What if I said to you, stilettos and suspenders, bring it on?
What if she said to you?
What if she said to you?
Well, I mean, it's the same as every other weekend.
Sounds far more exciting than it really is, but.
So well, speaking of exciting, I mean, we've got to go through this one here. My wife.
Yes.
Has an obsession with Rove McManus. Have you been sending in questions?
You wrote that yourself.
My wife has an obsession with Rove McManus. I find it hard to concentrate in our bedroom because there are pictures of him plastered everywhere.
Whoa.
Should I feel threatened by Rove from Albert in New South Wales?
We said lucky. Well, it could be pictures of Warwick Kappa. Now, come on.
That's just Warwick Kappa's bedroom that kills the mood.
Who was the person that wrote this? Albert.
Should Albert feel threatened that his wife has an obsession with me?
No, because I think Albert should send his wife to me for
suspenders and stilettos.
The bird documentaries, the Pears collection.
The ladies love it.
The wrestling figures, the farting.
Right. Excuse me.
We all fart.
No, you like introduce it.
Here we go.
It's not like I get like a set of curtains and say, drum roll, please.
Almost. You may as well.
But
so, anyway.
Yes, wind it up, Belvedere.
This is good. Keep going. Now, anything else?
I could go on and on. How long have we got?
Attention to what's on the walls, then there's got to be something going wrong in the bed.
I'm into that. Maybe he's not farting enough. Maybe that's all I can say. Well, please thank Lauren, Ann-Maree and Belinda. Thank you. All the best to Dad, of course. And now, here's Moira. Thank you very much, Moira. We'll be back with music from Carl Wagner. That's him just there. This is Rove McManus, and look, a lot of you are probably missing Bert, so we've just got a little something just to make you feel a little bit more at home. There we go. All right, now here to perform for us is Carl Wagner. Wagner? Do you like Wagner? Can I call you Wagner? Wagner. Carl Wagner performing with him, Mark Amato, Liza, Joni, Dave, Dion, Gavin and Jason. Stand by me.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we see, no, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand. Stand by me. Whoa, 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 yeah.
Stand by me.
Stand by me.
Stand by me.
Hey, baby, won't you stand?
Stand by me.
Stand by me.
Stand by me.
Stand by me. Oh, when the sky that we look upon should crumble and fall.
part of GMA today, and a special hello to Bert, of course, wishing you all the best for a speedy recovery. I've had a great time here today, but that's all we've got time for. Thanks very much. Say hi to your mum for me. Good night.
All things sport with the beautiful Christy Malthouse.
In London for a couple of years, so it's nice to be back now.
Are you more of an NRL or an AFL?
Oh, I'm Sydney boy, so a bit more of an NRL kind of guy, but a big weekend in the AFL this weekend.
A big weekend in the AFL, yes, and on Friday night it all on Friday night it all kicked off with West Coast and Essendon in Perth. Now, you wouldn't have thought they were playing in Perth with the rain that they had there, the heavy rain. It just poured the entire game. Kevin Sheedy stood on the sidelines and coached from the sidelines, almost like the NFL style, that what you see in America.
He's got an igniting passion, isn't he, Sheeds? He gets down there and gets stuck into it.
Oh, and look.
Thank you very much, Jers and Trinidad and Band Jers, and perhaps some moonface hair magic could help. What a ride. I've had a great time. I hope you have too. Don't miss tomorrow morning's GMA when we hand the ignition keys to Australian Idol's Mark Holden. He'll be chatting to Aussie legend Jack Thompson, who has got a couple of movies out. A whole lot more lined up for you. Don't miss it. Thank you very much, cast and crew. It's been a pleasure. Good morning, Australia.
With less than a year until the Melbourne Commonwealth Games, the Aussie netballers are already preparing to win their third consecutive gold medal. And someone who will play a part of that is Captain Liz Ellis.
Thank you.
Plug, 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 plug first. Let's get the plug.
The plug's great. It's my new book, Netball Heroes, 30 Greats of the
that?
Game.
There we go. How about that one?
I think I've been very humble on the front cover because I've actually included a photo of myself getting my butt kicked by Irene goal shooter, New Zealand goal shooter Irene van Dijk, and she's in one of the people included in the book. I haven't been too choosy. I've got Australian players and New Zealand players in there. Essentially, the
come on GMA coming up after the break. Some arresting music from the boys in blue.
Would never ever end, 'cause I'd have all the money in the world if I was away.
fantastic. And if you would actually like to see them, you can see them. We got some dates here. We got some dates we can show.
We
there they go. Okay, you can see them at the Curnow Hall, Morwell, and Clayton Hall, Clayton. And if you want to buy the album Divas, you can look on our website on GMA, and you will find that there. It's time for me to vacate the big seat. Tomorrow, Quarters will be in the driver's seat, so stay tuned. He will be with Andrew Gaze and Lindsay Gaze, Tanya Zayeta, who talks about Bollywood. Huey's in the kitchen. Leah Hudson talks kids biz. I'm going too fast. Is it all over? Oh, no, it can't be all over. Can I leave you with one last thing, other than saying thank you to everybody here at GMA? Can I just say this? Don't hassle the Hoff. That's it for me.
Look at that.
Welcome back to GMA. Our own Mark Amato joins me now on the couch. Now, we were just talking about your surname, Amato.
That's right.
And I thought, that reminds me.
Can I just say this? Don't hassle the Hoff. That's it for me.
Oh, look at that.
Welcome back to GMA. Our own Mark Amato joins me now on the couch. Now, we were just talking about your surname, Amato.
That's right.
And I thought, that reminds me of Latin, Amo, Amas, Amatum, or something like this.
Well,
what does it mean?
Loved.
Loved.
Loved in Italian.
Mark loved.
Yes.
But it's in the past tense. That's sad, isn't it?
No. Nothing sad.
Are you in love?
I'm always in love.
Are you? That's nice.
I'm in love with life.
Oh, are you?
At the moment, I'm in love with you.
You're in love with me? You're sounding a bit slimy. Are you related to Belinda?
No, not at all.
Now, what about you? I mean, other people get junkets overseas.
Yep.
And you got a junket down the road for the Umbria Jazz Festival.
Correct. I didn't have to go to Umbria this time because Umbria came to us a little while ago.
Now, where is Umbria in a traditional
sense? I think we have a little graphic here so we can show that we're all familiar with Italy, the boot.
Yep.
And Umbria is right in the heart of Italy. So it's actually referred to as Il Cuore d'Italia, which is the heart of Italy. And I was able to go and do a little story on a few of the people that came up for the festival.
All right, now it's a jazz festival, but it also had cooking or...
Cooking, ceramics, a whole heap of things that are specific to the region of Umbria.
Now, what is that region? I mean, we all know Tuscany, famous for vineyards and sweeping valleys and lovely old houses. Yep. What's Umbria look like?
It's quite undulating. It's hills and very green, a lot of pastures. It's got, it's quite agricultural, but it's a magical place.
All right. So was it nearly as good going to the jazz festival as going to Umbria itself?
Well, I haven't actually been through Umbria.
All right, but you
in
have
Italy.
Been. Did you? What did you do? Because you filmed some stuff for us.
Yeah.
What are we going to see?
I ate a heap of...
Ate like a pig?
Yeah.
Are you going to show us this?
Yes, let's
All
go.
All right, let's have a look. A little weird and wacky. Opas, good morning.
Good morning.
Now, you two have written this wonderful book, Weird and Wacky. Mm-hmm. Now, you're the writer and you're the photographer, is that right?
Yes, basically.
And you're a couple?
IT support and all that sort of thing.
All right. You're a married couple?
Yes.
And your marriage has survived, travelling all over the world?
Yes.
Wonderfully.
Do you agree on that?
Yes.
All right. Now, where did you get the idea of the weird and wacky?
Well, I'm rather taken with things like that, so I've been keeping cuttings for a long time and putting them aside. And after September 11, travel got a little bit sad, a little bit scary, and I thought we need to lighten up, we need to give people some reason to still want to travel and some fun things to do.
So how long have you spent researching this book in terms of actually travelling around and...
Oh, years, I suppose, really, if you count all the times that we've travelled, yeah.
But have you been to every one of these
About
places
a third
now?
Of them. Mm-hmm.
Aren't you lucky? Mm. And that's your job, writing about travel.
Yeah, food and travel, yeah.
And... Well, it's a delicious life isn't it?
Someone's got to do it.
Now, you're telling me, you do it together, but it's not quite in the same room, is it?
No, definitely not. His office is upstairs, mine's downstairs.
And how do you communicate?
We email.
You email each other?
It's the best way. You don't interrupt, you put flags on things, you know, men forget.
I have evidence that I have communicated and he can't say he's forgotten. I didn't tell him.
Did this test the relationship, choosing what was going into the book?
Or? No, I did that.
Oh, okay. What exactly did you do?
I did a lot of the sourcing of the images, a lot of the pictures of my own, a lot of the research side of it, many hours on the internet.
It's fabulously researched.
And all the IT side of it as well.
Yeah,
it's side of it.
So, I mean, I just love it. And the idea of travelling around and finding these really obscure things. Now, what would be your favourite? I like the underwater post box.
That's very unusual.
Now, so where is it?
That's at Vanuatu. And you can dive down with your letter and post it yourself, or if you don't want to dive, you get one of the staff and they'll take it down, put a waterproof stamp on it.
But do you have to put the letter in a plastic bag?
I'm not too sure what they do.
You
but
don't have to lick the stamp, that's all.
No, I would imagine. You wouldn't have to. Now, what's your favourite? And I know there are probably a million of them.
There are. There's so many. The bog snorkelling is very unusual.
Now, what is bog snorkelling?
It's exactly what it sounds like. There's this town in Wales that's very, very small. I think it's the smallest town in the whole of the UK. They had a meeting and said, look, what have we got here to attract people? What can we do? And they said, all we've got is a bog. That's all we've got.
A bog being like a huge puddle of mud.
A bog.
Not a little room.
No. So you don't see anything?
No, so you're snorkelling sort of blind in this.
And presumably it's freezing.
Yeah.
If you're snorkelling, you suck that in. You're in deep bog.
Well, there's a goal for the family.
August, September, I think, so it's not too bad.
All right.
Weather-wise.
So this book is full of exciting things like
strange
bog snorkeling.
Things, extreme ironing.
Extreme ironing.
Ironing underwater.
Fantastic. Mm. I love this book. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Sally and Gordon, thank you. Terrific book. Now, from the weird and wacky to the wise and wonderful, here's Moira. Roller shutters. Thanks, Moira. Coming up, the beautiful music of Peter Couples. Just zipped off the screen, but hopefully you memorised all of that. All right, here he is, accompanied by the gorgeous Mark Amato and joined by David, Steve and Simon, here with a track from his new album, Peter Couples with I Surrender. Thank you, Peter Couples and band. That was absolutely wonderful. And that is the show for today. Tomorrow, the big news is that the big man is back. On behalf of Bert, I'd like to thank Rove, Daniel, Mark and Stephen for helping out over this last week or so. And I'd like to thank all of you for joining us today and all of my guests. Thank you very, very much. You've been watching GMA. Oh, wait a minute. There's a word from the director. Oh, it's time to go. Belvedere.